Hello, so let's begin the new line. D4 knight f6, c4 e6, knight f3 d5, knight c3, bishop b4, and queen b3. This move is played in the spirit of classical variation of Nimtse Indian defense. So white wants to take on c3 with the queen, and white wants to prove that the pair of bishop is small but long-term advantage. And black plays c5. That's the critical position. The next three videos are about d takes c5 and c takes d5. And in this video, I'll talk about all other possible moves for white. So let's start. e3. We play knight c6. With the idea of taking on d4 and on taking on c4 and protecting the bishop. Of course, dc, bishop c5 is nothing. If cd, ed, dc, then it's good time to castle, and then black can take on c5 with the bishop. And if bishop b5, then castles. And white should take on c5 at some point, because if castle, then c4 and black is already slightly better. What if a3 now? White wants us to play bishop c3 and queen takes c3, but black has a small trick: knight a5, queen c2, bishop c3. And black wants to take on c4 with the knight. So with bc3, then knight takes c4, bishop takes c4, d takes c4, queen a4, bishop d7, queen takes c4, and queen a5. And black is already slightly better, uses bishop b5 idea at some lines. So queen takes c3, c takes d4, and it's an equal position. It takes d4, knight c4, bishop c4, d takes c4, queen takes c4, and castles. But at some point, black is slightly better due to the isolated d4 pawn. Or knight d4, that's more solid approach. Knight c4, bishop c4, d takes c4, queen c4, castles, and castles. And here, black should have played e5 with the idea bringing the bishop on g4, knight f3, rook e4, and bishop g4. We saw similar positions when discussing queen a4, e3 line. So it's just the symmetrical position. It's just an equal middle game position. Other approach for white: a3. Bishop takes c3. And actually, b takes c3 is better move, because after queen takes c3, black takes c takes d4, and knight takes d4 is already a mistake, because e5. The best move is knight b5, because knight f3, d4, queen c2, Kachetkov against Majorov game. Here, black should have played e4, knight d2, and queen e7, and black is much better to you. The lead to in the development. So knight b5, castles, c takes d5, knight takes d5, and black has the lead in development, so black is better. So queen d4 is better try, but knight c6, everything with tempos, queen h4 and e5, the idea playing bishop e6. If cd, queen d5, so best move for white is bishop g5, bishop a6, bishop f6, g takes f6, and black is better, because the lead in the development. But if bishop h6, the idea like in the Scandinavian defense with reversed cover, that move is just bad, because white loses after bishop g4, bishop g7, and suddenly queen a5 check, and black has the winning attack. Also, bishop g5 is nothing, just d takes c4, queen takes c4, and queen b6. and black is better. So it's typical for this line. If white makes many moves with the queen, white position can become worse. So e3 is solid approach, but however black is slightly better. In any case, bishop e6, if bishop e2 just taken on c4, or c takes d5, queen d5, bishop e2 castles, bishop d2 and queen e4, and black will take back the d2 bishop, and black is slightly better. So white should take b takes c3, but now the queen b3 move is not very logical because black plays knight c6 and white should spend some tempos with the queen. C takes d5 and e takes d5. We saw similar positions already. I talked about these two big squares and everything like in the previous lines. For example, d takes c5 and knight e4, and pinning from this possible pin and attacking the c5 pawn. e3, queen a5, bishop b2, castles, queen b5, a6, queen a5, knight a5, rook d1, and bishop e6, and black was better in Mincheff Alvarez Pedraza game. Maybe best for white is to play bishop g5, bringing the bishop outside the pawn chain, but black plays c4, queen b5, a6, queen b2, and h6 with an equal position. That was a3 line, and now the most critical from these three lines is the move bishop g5. So we don't want to play h6, bishop f6, queen takes f6, cd, ed, because that's very popular position, and we don't need to be in this position when we facing the main line. So in the main line, white plays cd, ed, bishop g5, h6, bishop f6, queen f6, and after queen b3, we don't play c5, transposing into this position, but we play queen b6. So we don't want to know much theory, and that line is quite a theoretical one. So we choose another approach. So don't be move ordered. Just remember that in this position you take d takes c4, and black easily equalizes because white plays queen takes c4 and c takes d4. It's already a novelty, but white has nothing. Let's see some lines. We can take on d4, we can take on f6, we can just play rook d1, we can take on b4. On knight d4, we play knight a6, protecting the bishop. If e3, then bishop d7, queen b3, because rook c8, you know, it's a threat. Now, queen b3, queen a5, bishop a6, bishop c3, queen c3, and queen a6. And white cannot castle short, so black is better. If e4, then bishop d7, and white can blunder a pawn by playing a5 and queen a5. Black is better. So the best move for white is just queen b5, queen d7 to exchange the queens, and the position is more or less equal. That was knight takes d4. If bishop f6, remember our bishop hangs, so bishop takes c3, b takes c3, and g takes f6. If knight takes d4, then bishop d7, e3, and knight a6 with a equal position. If c takes d4, then queen a5 check, knight d2, and bishop d7. And this position is more or less equal. If rook d1, then bishop c3 also, b takes c3, castles. If rook d4, then just knight bd7, and then black wants to play queen a5. So c takes d4 is better, but bishop d7. Good move, and white actually can lose into one move by playing e3, queen a5. White cannot go king e2 due to bishop b5, and white cannot play rook d2 due to knight e4, and of course not knight d2 because this bishop is hanging. But if white plays e4, queen a5, bishop d2, queen a4, black is better anyway. So the best move is actually queen b3, but then black plays queen b6, bishop d2, bishop c6, c3, and rook c8 with a balanced position. Of course, queen b4 is the most logical move, but here black wins the tempo by playing knight c6, queen c4, and d takes c3, queen takes c3, and bishop d7. So our idea is the same, bringing the rook into the play as quickly as possible. e3, rook c8, bishop e2, h6, everything is changes on f6, and we have a very drawish endgame. But that's about this four sorry five queen b3 line, because this line is very solid. It remains as an in defense. So if you are playing against Rogozin with power white, I can tell you that that's the most solid approach from all the lines we will discuss to play 5 queen b3. So in this video we talked about queen b3 c5, and we analyze e3, a3, and bishop g5, and by making usual moves black just equalizes. The only real point is that after bishop g5 we don't want to castle, transposing it to the line outside our repertoire. We just should remember d takes e4, queen c4, and c takes d4. It's maybe the only important move order in this video. So thanks for watching this video, and in the next videos we will talk about what happens if white takes on d5 or on c5. See you again soon. Goodbye.